Now about distribution money between Chinese soccer and other sports. Well, first of all, you have to spend most money for Jenny Langping, because you spend money on the Chinese national women volleyball team because they are the best. And then you can spend some money on both basketball teams, the males and the females, and then you can spend money on the women's soccer team, and then you can spend money on badminton, Li Yongbo, or swimming. Yeah, you have to spend money on Sun Yang, of course, and Ning Zetao and Fu Yuanhui and so on. And you should spend the, you should spend least money on soccer in China, especially for males. You can spend lots of money for women's soccer there in China because they are really, they're at least better than the males counterpart. And then, and you have to spend money on track and field for Su Bingtian and Xie Zhenye and so on. And they are really good. So you spend money for the best of the best. Now for the Winter Olympics, you have to spend money on skating, more on skating, I think, because you use the figure skating and biathlon, Liu Xianying, but that wasn't known in China. So and ice hockey is something really difficult because. Ice hockey, they have Na Ying and Ying Da and the great aunt of Rudy Ying was a famous actress at that time and between the anti-Japanese war, and she has spent money for the national troops against the Japanese invaders. So Na Ying, Ying Da, and Rudy Ying, they are the famous. But you also need the other, especially Chinese Canadians. You have to, get them their Chinese citizenship back because Yip and Kim, and there are lots of Chinese Canadians playing the sport. And also in Germany, you have the Wonder Girl, of course, Lola Liang. At Frankfurt Löwen, Lola Liang is the best, and they are all on elite prospects. So it's like you put a database on soccer is fupa.net, and then you have elite prospects for ice hockey. So for the Winter Olympics, they really have to use something like that. And the American team, they want to beat the Chinese team 20-0, and the Canadian team will beat them 30-0. So that's why they don't boycott the games, because if they boycott it, they cannot beat them so high. So they want to play, and then they beat them, 20-0, I think, and then that's why they want to join the games and at Beijing Olympics.